thought that the first task went pretty well. Our group had some adding problems, which is really surprising because I think maybe all of our group is in an honors math class, so I thought that was a little ironic. But for the most part, it went pretty well. We kind of got confused in which direction to go on the street, but we got it right, so that's all good.
It sort of seemed like there was some shifty stuff going on in my group when we were figuring it out, but it all turned out okay.
It's really difficult to form suspicions this early on because everyone seemed really helpful. They were all keeping up. They were all providing information. We were really, really trying to solve the riddles. So at this point, I honestly didn't learn that much from this task, other than a lot of the people in the group are slow runners.
My suspicions right now are Emily, Zeke, and John. So I was in a group with Emily and Zeke, and they both were kind of lagging behind and stopped many times when they knew we were in a hurry, so.
I have a few suspicions of who I think might be the mole. I'm thinking Brent, because when we were doing our little first challenge, he couldn't do the math. And I've known Brent since like kindergarten, and he's amazing at math.
I don't know, I'm hoping Cassie. That's the hardest for me.
I'm probably just going with Brent because I have no idea what Cassie is like, so.
I think it's Brent because he is really good at math and he wasn't doing like any of the math correct. So I just have a feeling that it's Brent.
The thing that got me about Brent is he forgot how many vowels and letters were in your name.
That's retarded.
I mean, weren't you guys like really good friends too?
We're kind of.
Yeah. So he shouldn't know your name. He was actually going Z.
Maybe he was doing my last name too.
Yeah.
Brittany?
No, Brittany was actually really well. She's like the only one who noticed that it wasn't like triple digits, it was quads, so we had to do the math. So if she was the mole, she wouldn't have said anything.
Yeah.
And Brent was just like.
That's cool.
Was like, he was like.
Huh.
So I'm gonna go for Brown, of course. I don't know.
That might be twins. I don't know, it's like really up in the air.
I know, it's really up in the air, especially since it's the first challenge. And this one's like so easy to mess up even if you're not the mole.
Oh, I heard Brent, he doesn't even remember my name, like I heard, like the B team came over, and they're like, oh my god, we think it's Brent, and I was like, what is that? And then they like just listed what he did, and I was like, it's kind of weird.
And you know, I just want to say, my looks may not look like I know what's going on, but really it's all up here.
Almost, that's my gut instinct when I'm going with it.
I really do, I agree with you. It's just like we're trying to calculate all these numbers, and she's just...
And our whole group was like, we were sprinting the whole time, and we had all the math, and we were looking, I think.
Our group had some problems at the beginning. We can't do math, so we couldn't find the address of the house, but we found it with like 4 minutes to go and sprinted back. Actually, only about half of us sprinted, and the other half just took their time,
you know, just walking along, doing whatever. I'm like, hurry, run!
I'm going with this.
I am too.
And I'm in college, and I'm very intelligent. Therefore, I think I've got it. And we just did a perception exercise where I talked to this guy I didn't know, and where I had to answer 10 random questions about him, and I only missed one, and that was the best in the class. And so, I'm thinking I've got a pretty good idea, and I'm just gonna go with that.
If one of us gets executed, then we're wrong.
Exactly, there you go. Good plan.
I think it's Brent, because there's a short girl last time, and he's a tall boy. And he's wearing a really funny looking hat. And he wasn't on my team, and I don't know, he just kind of seems like a sabogatory type. That's a new word, sabogatory, if I see him around.
I think the fact that my twin is competing in this and that he was in my group is an advantage for me. To tell you the truth, I think that I can read him fairly well, and I think that if he's the mole, it'll be really easy for me to catch on and stay in the game long enough to eventually win the pot. So I guess there's a little bit of a twist here because we're twins in this game, and I don't really know if each one of us is a mole or not, so we'll just have to see. I think Scott's fairly easy to read, so it's definitely an advantage on my part.
Okay guys, you're about to take your first execution quiz.
Woo!
There are 10 questions about the mole. Remember, the player who scores the lowest is executed. Now, if there's a tie, slowest person will lead.
Well, I really don't have any clue who the person is, so I'm gonna just do the most common of everyone. So let's say the most common middle school, the most common whatever. And then hopefully someone will just be stupid and vote for me, being that I'm totally out there and totally not common at all, and I'll be higher than them.
Number one, is the mole male or female?
I think the mole is just sort of hiding right now and waiting for the chance to strike so everybody doesn't figure out who they are. So I guess we'll just have to wait and see.
I don't know who's the mole though, and that's really bothering me.
Number two, from which direction did the mole arrive?
I'm feeling pretty good. I think I might know who the mole is if he was in our group.
Number three, how many people were in the mole's entering group?
I haven't really seen much suspicious activity, but it's still early.
Number four, who stood to the right of the mole when everyone first lined up?
Got my suspicions.
Number five, was the mole in group A or B?
I have an inkling of a maybe of who the mole is.
Number six, was the mole's group back first or last?
Whoever's the mole, I think, is kind of played on the DL the first round, which kind of makes it confusing.
Number seven, is the mole currently in a relationship?
I'm thinking either Cassie or Brent.
Number eight, how tall is the mole?
I just don't know what to choose.
I think it's Brent Sundell, just because like during the challenge we had a thing where like we had to find three of each letter and he thought there'd be three in each name, and he was so persistent on that, and that just like threw us off by like eight streets.
Number nine, in which year was the mole born?
I'm pretty certain, almost 90%, I already have them all figured out.
And number 10, who is the mole?
Welcome, everybody, to your first execution. 10 of you are safe. One of you is not. Inside of this container, 11 envelopes. In 10 of them, a green fingerprint. That means you're safe. In one of them, a red fingerprint, which means you've been executed and are the mole's first victim. Let's begin. You are safe.
I'm the shiznit. What?
Brittany. You're safe. Let's do Gabrielle next. You are safe.
Yes! Yes! Safe. Come on.
Yes! Yes! Safe.
My it was right scary. Here, you kind of pulled it slower.
Kyle. You are safe.
Good job.
Cassie. You are safe. Let's go with Steven. Where's Steven?
Here. Back away from Steven.
That's because you know it's not
Steven. Oh! You're safe, Steven. Scott next. Scott, Sierra.
Back away from Sierra.
You're safe. That means we're down to Brent and Emily. One of you is safe, one of you is leaving.
Which
one?
Brent. Oh. The first victim. Brent, why don't you say your goodbye and come with me?
I was like, wow, there didn't
Sorry, Brent. Sorry, Brent.
Sorry, Brent.
For you.
Yeah.
You suck.
So what are your reactions to being the first person executed?
Not as bad as I thought. I think I'm gonna go home and go to sleep. I don't know, you know, it's just kind of me and Emily. Obviously I answered worse than she did. So I don't know if she's gonna have to change her strategy.
Okay, well we'll see you later this evening.